Welcome to Dunlop's tyre testing facility in the south of France near Montpellier. We've been invited over here to be a part of the development team for the day that's putting together the new sport touring tyre called the RoadSmart, which replaces the D220. Now behind us you can see a bit of their test track. If we move further along here, you can see their wet weather test track, which is pretty cool. Now we're going to go out and have a look at the tyres in a minute, and part of our feedback will go towards the final production of the tyre. So if it's no good, you can blame me. Right, so this is how today's going to work. We're going to be riding all the competitors' tyres on the track, the dry track in the morning, and then on the wet track this afternoon. And then finally, we're going to ride on the prototype Road Smarts to see how it compares. And afterwards, we're going to evaluate the tyres for things like stability, rear grip, front grip, feeling on the braking, all those kind of things. So let's go and test. We've been here all day testing all the tyres, and quite a few interesting things have come out today. Not least, we've got to test all the main manufacturer's tyres on a dry track and a wet track. And the wet track's really weird, actually. It feels like you're riding through the streets of Venice. You've got the sun out and the splashing around on the wet tarmac. It feels really odd. But the main protagonists here were Metzeler's Rotec Z6, the Michelin Pilot Road 2, and the Bridgestone BT021. Now, out of all of those, the Michelin's much better in the wet than any of the others, and on the dry track, the Bridgestone has got it. So the big question is, how's the Dunlop compare at this stage? Now, I've got to stress that this isn't a final production tyre yet, but in the wet track, the Dunlop's actually 2 seconds faster than the Michelin. It gives much better grip, much better feel, and on the dry track, actually turns in quicker lap times than all the other tyres as well. So as it stands, it's looking really good. They've got a few more finishing touches to put to the tyre before it goes into production in October, and when we'll get to ride it again at the official press launch. But until then, I think they're on to a winner.